Good morning, dear children. Welcome back. In today's session, we will continue our learning process of Class 6, Term 1, Unit 2 in History, Human Evolution. This is Part 3 of the videos. Come children, let us dig into the past. Before going into today's session, let us have a recap of what we learned in the last ones. In the last sessions, we discussed the introduction part of the human evolution. It all started with around 460 crore years ago when the earth evolved. 20 lakh years ago, the man started to walk, and about 3 lakh years ago, he spread throughout the earth. 8,000 years ago started the civilization, and around 5,000 years ago, the civilizations flourished. Now, in present day, we can see the modern man. The story of human evolution can be scientifically studied with the help of archaeology and anthropology. Archaeology is a study of prehistoric human remained materials used by prehistoric humans. Excavated materials remain as a main source for archaeological studies. Anthropology is a study of humans and evolutionary history. Anthropologists attempt by investigating the whole range of human development and behavior to achieve a total description of cultural and social phenomena. Radiocarbon dating was used to ascertain the age of the period. The modern human evolved in three steps. First one is human in erect position and walking on two legs. Second one, change in thumb so that they could hold the things tightly. Third one was the development of brain. Homo sapiens, who migrated out of Eastern Africa, settled in different parts of the world. Their lifestyles also evolved suitable to the environment in which they are living. Based on weather, climate, and nature of living place, their physique and complexion differed. This resulted in the formation of different races. Human procreation resulted in an increase in the population. We also learned that our ancestors led a nomadic life. They lived in groups in caves or in mountain ranges, each group consisting of 30 to 40 people, and they kept on moving in search of food. They hunted animals. They learned the art of fishing. They collected honey from beehives, plucked fruits from trees, and dug out tubers from the ground. They wore hides of animals and barks of trees and leaves for protecting their bodies during winter. Hunting was the main occupation of humans in the past, and it was difficult for humans to kill a big animal with a stick or a stone. So they decided to use sharpened weapons. The best stone used was Chikimuki Kal or flint stone. It was known for its strength and durability. At first, the humans were afraid of fire and lightning. Probably fire caused by lightning had killed many wild animals. Humans tasted the flesh of killed animals, which was soft and tasty. This made humans aware of the effect of fire. The invention of the wheel was the first scientific invention of human beings using their brain and cognitive skills. It is considered as a foremost invention. They also learned to make pot with clay. Invention of wheel made pot making easier, and the pots made were burned to make it stronger. Color dyes were made from extract of roots and leaves or barks, and they were used in pot making. These colors were also used in rock paintings. Dear children, in this session, we'll discuss the ancient rock paintings. Dear children, in India, we can see many paintings in rocks and caves. The rock paintings give more information about the past. Approximately, there are 750 caves in which 500 caves have paintings. What you see on the picture is the cave paintings at Bhimbetka. The Bhimbetka cave shelters features more than 100 paintings. Some of them are more than 10,000 years old. Dear children, there are many more undiscovered caves. The rock paintings depict hunting pictures of male and female, dancing pictures, and pictures of children playing. So we can find a variety of descriptioning pictures in the rock paintings. It could be male pictures, female pictures, dancing, and children playing, and so on. Here you can find the cave paintings found in India. You can find the Bhimbetka cave paintings near Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh, Sitanvasal paintings in Pudukkottai district of Tamil Nadu, Ajanta caves near Aurangabad in Maharashtra, there you can find the Ellora caves also, Lenyadri cave paintings at Junnar in Maharashtra, Badami caves in Bangalkot district of Northern Karnataka, Adamgarg hills in Madhya Pradesh, Jogimara cave paintings in Chhattisgarh, Saspul caves in Leh district, Elephanta caves in Ellora district island in Maharashtra. These are for your general information. So many places we can find the cave paintings in India. Dear children, this picture shows the prehistoric rock art of Tamil Nadu. You can find Keelwali, Vilvilupuram, Uslampatti in Madurai, Kumuthupatti in Coimbatore, Mavadepa in Coimbatore, Porivare Cave in Karikailur in Nilgiris.
Oh, we are able to gain some knowledge about past lifestyle through these paintings, isn't it, Grandma?
So she's asking her grandma that we are able to gain some knowledge about the past lifestyle. So seeing these paintings, we can identify their lifestyles and we can get some knowledge about how they lived, how they survived. And grandma says, you said it rightly, Tamil. These rock and cave paintings tell us many stories about our ancestors. So from these rock paintings and cave paintings, we can get how the lifestyle of our ancestors were. They tell us stories about our ancestors.
Okay, Grandma. Now tell me how humans reached the next stage.
So she's asking her grandma, just tell me, what is the next stage? How did the humans reach the next stage? And grandma says, there were many dangers involved in hunting. Not only one, there were several dangers in hunting. Due to large-scale hunting in the mountain areas and in the forest, many animals became extinct. For example, when they hunted a deer, they are alone. What happens to the deer population? It will be getting extinct. It will be no longer available. Non-availability of meat forced the humans to look for fruits and vegetables for food. So once they could not get hold of meat, they started looking for vegetables and fruits as food. They stopped eating meat because meat was not available. So they started eating fruits and vegetables. And Tamilini says,
now they would have thought for producing food for themselves. Is it not, Grandma?
Now Tamilini says, so they would have thought of producing food for themselves because as the hunting progressed, the animals they hunted became extinct and they looked for fruits and vegetables. And once they understood that they could eat fruit and vegetable, they would have thought of producing food for themselves. Dear children, Grandma says, very well said, Tamil. That is absolutely right. The seed of fruits and nuts they ate were thrown into the soil. During rains, the soil gave it life. Some days later, the saplings sprouted from the soil. So they would have thrown the fruits and nuts, the seed, they would have thrown it outside in the wild. And during rain, it got life from soil and sprouts had come up. So dear children, by observation and logic, they were watching by observation, by seeing what was happening, they learned that plants grow from a single seed and yields lots of fruits and vegetables. A single seed only is needed to grow a plant and it produces lot of fruits and vegetables. Seeds that fall in the river beds sprout easily. They also understood that the seeds which were on the river beds grew faster and they sprouted quickly. Plants grow faster in water-fed areas. And the plants which grow, they grew faster in water-fed, where there was availability of water in that area, it grew very well. Alluvial soil is more suitable for plant growth than any other. So after observation and their logic, they by using their logic, they understood these things. That is, plant grow from a single seed and it gives a lot of fruits and vegetables. Seeds that fall in the riverbed will sprout easily. Plants can grow faster in water-fed areas, and alluvial soil is suitable for plant growth than any other. So they understood the basic techniques of agriculture, basic techniques of cultivation. Dear children, with the above knowledge they gained, they realized that with proper sowing and nurturing, they could increase the number of plants more than once that grew naturally. So they could, by using proper sowing and nurturing, by sowing the seeds properly and by taking care of the growing seeds, they could increase the number of plants more than once that grew naturally. So they could increase the number that was available naturally. By growing more, they could increase the number. Thus, agriculture and farming came into existence. This was the beginning of agriculture and farming. They domesticated the animals and used them in their farming. So they understood they can grow more crops, and they tried to tame or train the animals and use them in their farming. Dear children, breeding of animals now became an important part of their life. They wanted to breed animals. Breeding is a technique that ensures the improvement of a farm animal generation after generation. So, our prehistoric people understood the importance of breeding and they started practicing breeding of animals. Oxen were used for ploughing. So agriculture improved and they used oxen for ploughing. Oxen made the practice of agriculture easier. It could do the work more efficiently. Life was becoming organized than it was when they were hunting. Once they started to settle down in one place, life became more organized. It enabled them to settle down in a place. Since they started agriculture, they had to settle down in one place. Now with settlement came the problem of utensils and vessels for cooking and storage. So now they wanted to have the vessels and utensils for cooking. Once they were settled down in one place, they started growing their own crops. They started leading a settled life. They were in need of vessels for cooking and utensils. The invention of plow helped in the farming practices. Dear children, the potter's wheel and fire solved this problem, the problem of utensils and vessels. The invention of plow helped the farming practices. You can see the picture of a plow there and a potter's wheel. The plow helped the farming practices. Farming started with the clearing of land and burning the leftover shrubs. So people knew how to farm. They cleared the land and started burning the leftover shrubs. They plowed the land, sowed the seeds in them and harvested the produce. So they plowed the land, they sowed the seed and harvested. During the prehistoric period, humans lived in caves and depicted their daily events in drawings. So since they were living in caves, they wanted to depict how they are living in the caves as drawings and or rock paintings and drawings. Mostly pictures of animals were drawn. They were related to the animals. It was very important to them. So they drew the picture of the animals. Dear children, once the fertility of the soil decreased, that is, they started cultivating in one place for a long time, the fertility will decrease. Then they moved to a new place. Then they moved on to a new place. Initially, agriculture was done for immediate food requirement. They did agriculture, immediate food requirement. What they needed as food, they cultivated. Later, when they found out ways to increase production, they started storing the produce. So once they knew how to increase the production of a crop, they started storing the produce. Whatever they produced, they started storing it. The food products stored were used during the lean harvest period. So they were using the stored food for a lean harvest. So they knew how to store the produce and lose it later on. And dear children, by their experience, they understood that land close to the riverside was suitable for farming. So they understood that the land which was closer to the riverside was the best for farming. And so they decided to stay there permanently. So they started staying near the riverside permanently because it was very good for farming. Now Tamilini is asking Grandma something. Tamilini.
How about domestication of animals, Grandma?
Now she wants to know about the domestication of animals. That is why they were keeping dogs and other animals with them. Grandma says, humans thought of ways to better their skill at hunting. They wanted to improve their skills at hunting. They found out that dogs could sniff other animals and chase them away. So they identified dogs could sniff other animals better than them and they could chase them away. So humans found them useful for hunting. So they started taking dogs for hunting. Dear children, thus dogs became the first animal to be domesticated by humans. So dogs were first domesticated by humans because of its sniffing skill. Following the dogs, they started domesticating hen, goat and cow. So following the dogs, they started rearing the hen, goat and cow naturally for their eggs and the milk. Now Tamilini is asking Grandma,
what next?
So she's asking Grandma, after that, what is the next thing? That is, after the domestication of animals, what was the next thing? Grandma says, humans stayed on the plains for a long time. That is, they were on the plains for a long time. During this period, they have not only learnt agriculture, but slowly developed the skills of handicrafts. So once they started living on the plains, they started learning agriculture and also developed skill of handicrafts. Permanent settlement in a place increased the yield of crops. Since they were in one place, it also increased the yield because they knew better about the soil. Now they had grains in excess of what they consumed. So they had always excess of grain than they consumed. The surplus grains were exchanged with other groups for the other things they were in need of. So with the excess grains what they had, they exchanged with the other groups of people with the things they wanted. This is called the barter system. What is it called as? Barter system. Exchanging of things with other groups for the things they are in need of. Thus, trade and commerce developed in towns and cities emerged. So what is barter system, children? Exchange of goods for other goods is called as barter system. And once the barter system was there, trade and commerce developed. People wanted to give and take more things. And hence, towns and cities also developed. Now let us see the summary of the lesson. Evolution means the process in which humankind changes and develops into an advanced stage. Homo sapiens migrated out of Eastern Africa and settled in different parts of the world. Humans, with the help of Chikimukikal, that is Flintstone, made sharp weapons and tools. Fire was used by early human to protect him from predators, for cooking food and for the light during night. The invention of wheel is considered to be the foremost invention. It made pot making easier. We get knowledge about the past lifestyle through rock paintings. Now let us go through the glossary, children. Time machine. That is a machine capable of taking a person backward and forward in time. So you can go back and forth in time using a time machine. Evolution. It's a gradual change leading to a more advanced development. Evolution. Predator. Animal that hunts and kills other living things for food. footprints. The impression of the foot of a person or an animal. Hides, a stand skin of animal. Million, 100,000 or 10 lakhs. Million is 100,000 or 10 lakhs. Nomadic, herdsman without any fixed home, moving about in search of pastures for their cattle. Nomadicus, herdsman without any fixed home, moving about in search for pastures for their cattle. Barter, exchange of goods without involving money. Prey, an animal that is hunted and killed by another for food. Time for recap. In this session, we discussed the ancient rock paintings and settlements. In India, we can see many paintings in rocks and caves. These rock paintings give some information about the past. The dangers in hunting were many animals became extinct and there was no availability of meat, and it forced the humans to look for fruits and vegetables. Then they observed nature and found that they could grow fruits and vegetables. So they started cultivating, and thus agriculture and farming came into existence. They domesticated animals and they used them for farming. They also found out the breeding of animals. Once the life became organized, they needed to settle down in one place and they were in need of utensils and vessels. Potter's wheel and fire was a solution to this problem. Once agriculture improved, they had to store their excess produce so that they could use in the time of lean harvest period. The surplus grains there exchanged with other groups for the other things they were in need of, and hence started the barter system. Dear children, in the next session, we will discuss the book back exercises. Now it's time for worksheet. Worksheet number 3. Roman number 1. Fill in the blanks. Question number 1. The invention of dash made farming easier. The invention of dash made farming easier. Question number 2. Rock paintings are found at Dash in Nilgiris. Rock paintings are found at Dash in Nilgiris. Roman number 2. Answer the following. How would you define archaeology? How would you define archaeology? Question number 2. What do you know about anthropology? What do you know about anthropology? Question number 3. When did humans settle in one place? When did humans settle in one place? With that, we wind up today's session, children. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe our YouTube channel, youtube.com/samachir kalvi guide. Thank you.